الصلاة والسلام على أشرف المرسلين سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقهوا قولي. Dear brothers and sisters in Islam, today we have another place in the life of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. And this place is known as the seven prophetic gardens, or the seven charitable gardens of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Seven gardens in Medina, known to have been possessed by the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And the seven have got a very special story. We all know that there were Jews in Medina before the Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam came to Medina. Three big tribes were known: Banu Nadir, Banu Qurayza, and Banu Qaynuqa. Banu Nadir and Banu Qurayza, in fact, were Arab tribes that converted to Judaism, while Banu Qaynuqa were Israelis who migrated to Medina long before Islam. These were the three famous tribes of the Jews in Medina, but there were other tribes. One of the other tribes was Banu Thalaba and Banu Zawra. From Banu Thalaba, there was a rabbi, like a priest, a Jewish priest or a Jewish imam rabbi. His name was Mukhayriq. Mukhayriq was a rabbi who had knowledge about Judaism and who found that the message of the Prophet was so convincing and so sound. So he used to argue with his uncles and the people of Banu Thalaba, and he used to say, تَعْلَمُونَ أَنَّهُ النَّبِيُّ الَّذِي بَشَّرَكُمْ بِهِ مُوسَى تَعْلَمُونَ أَنَّ عَلَيْكُمْ اتِّبَاعًا. You know for sure that this is the Prophet that Moses told you about. And you know for sure that you should follow him and you should support him. But then they should argue back to him and say that he doesn't seem to be that prophet. Till the day of the Battle of Uhud came, and the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam took the Muslims in order to fight against the infidels, the mushrikeen that come from Quraysh to the north of Medina near the Mount of Uhud. Then Mukhayriq told his kinsmen that I'm going to fight with Muhammad and you have to go and fight with me there. Because it was a Saturday. And for the Jews, this was the Sabbath, in which they did not fight, in which they did not do anything. So they said, we agree that we have to fight with Muhammad, but this is the Sabbath. Then he said, La sabta lakum. You don't know and you don't recognize the meaning, the real meaning of Sabbath. So he said, I'm going to fight with Muhammad. And if I die, all my positions should go to Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and he will do in them whatever he likes. It was like an endowment. It was the first waqf in Islam. The first waqf in Islam was established by a Jew, not by a Muslim. And he went to the Prophet, and the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was in the middle of the distress, because we know that in the Battle of Uhud, there were two phases of the battle. In the first phase, the Muslims were victorious, but then the arrow throwers got down from the mount, and they disobeyed the order of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So this was the second phase where the Muslims were defeated. Mukhayriq came to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam in the middle of this distress and said, Ya Rasulullah, should I declare or embrace Islam and then fight, or should I fight first and then embrace Islam? أُسْلِمُ وَأُقَاتِلْ أَمْ أُقَاتِلُ وَأُسْلِمْ. Then the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, embrace Islam first and then go to fight. So he said, أَشْهَدُ أَنْ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهُ وَأَشْهَدُ أَنَّ مُحَمَّدًا رَسُولُ اللَّهِ, and went into the battle and he was killed. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam called him a martyr, although he did not pray any rak'ahs in his life. And when the Prophet asked about him after the battle and knew that he was killed, he said sallallahu alaihi wasallam, Mukhayriq khayru yahud. Mukhayriq is the best of the Jews. Then the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam knew that seven gardens were possessed by Muhayrin, and that these seven gardens were endued on the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and now he possessed them. And we know that all the possessions of Prophets, especially Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, are not real possessions, they are charitable possessions after their death. The seven gardens are still there, and they have been recorded by place and by name in the books of Seerah. We know that these seven gardens are Al-A'waf, Al-Maythab, Barqa, Husna, Al-Safiyya, Al-Mashraba, and Al-Dilaa. These are seven names for the seven gardens of the Prophet ﷺ.